Paige?
Yes?
It's Mickey.
Hello?
Paige, I've got to see you. It's really important. I've got to see you today.
I don't know if I can get the time.
You've got to make the time, Paige. This might be my last night in Monticello. Listen, my address is 63 Fremont Street, third floor. Can you remember that?
Yeah, I got it.
I'll be waiting for you, Paige.
Nothing like a little traveling money. You can't tell the players without a scorecard. Jed, Louise, and Zach. That's the end of the team. Nobody to split with now. Or is there?
I had a little talk with Chief Marceau before he left.
What?
I told him that I did not like the idea of having all police protection lifted, Paige, as long as Tobias is around.
Oh, Brian, stop it. I'm tired of hearing you say that.
I just can't understand how you could go on protecting this ski mask hoodlum. If it weren't for him, none of this would have ever happened.
I chose to go with Toby and the other members of the gang. Nobody twisted my arm.
And you still see this two-bit punk as some kind of an idealist, huh? A protector of the poor and the oppressed.
Toby initiated the scheme to get guns to the guerrilla fighters so they could overthrow the dictator.
And all Tobias wanted was a statue of himself in the town square after the people reclaimed the reins of government, right?
We didn't want anything.
Well, that is not Chief Marceau's theory, Paige.
Well, Chief Marceau is wrong. Toby didn't get 1 cent out of this deal.
What about the report that the guerrillas accepted a huge bundle of cash?
Simply isn't true. They were poor farmers. Where would they get the money from?
They could have raised it, Paige. That's not the point. You should have contacted the authorities as soon as Tobias got in touch with you. They could have put a tap on the phone. They could have increased surveillance. They may have caught up with him and gotten to the truth.
Toby doesn't belong in prison.
Paige, from everything I have heard, Tobias is at least unsavory. You talk about him like he's Mr. Wonderful.
You didn't know him as I did.
How well did you know him, Paige?
What do you mean?
One of the reasons that people won't accept the truth about a person is because of the way they feel towards them. Now, you have always denied that there was anything between you and Tobias but friendship. Well, Paige, I'm beginning to wonder whether that's really the truth.
Just as I said, Owen, seek and ye shall find.
Hey, we're not producing a biblical epic, Eddie. I think a very good witch was on our side this morning.
How you doing, kids?
Paige and I were just trying to decide whether we wanted to play in the sandbox or on the swings.
What Brian is trying to tell you, Uncle Eddie, is that we are no longer kids. Oh, sometimes I wish we were.
Anyway, beautiful, you're going to be making pictures sooner than you expect.
Mm. How many times have you used that line, Uncle Eddie?
Hey, look, honey, today we made one giant step closer to getting Mansion of the Damned into production.
How'd your meeting with Mr. Ralston go?
Oh, it was okay, and the price he asked was fair, but the production house that he operates is geared for local commercial production. The soundstage is just way too small for a feature film.
Yeah, Ralston did put us onto something that was just the ticket, though.
Yeah, he told us about this old movie studio on the outskirts of town. Apparently the Army built it during World War II and used it to make those training films.
You know, those classics, Your Mess Kit, A G.I.'s Best Friend, and How to Grease Your M1 for Fun and Profit.
Anyway, the place has been deserted for years, and it's a bit of a wreck. But I think with a minimal amount of renovation, the soundstage should be workable.
You know, the government's been trying to get rid of that place for a long time. I bet we could pick that up for a song, Owen.
Yeah.
So it's definite we'll be doing this movie in Monticello?
I told Eddie that's the one stipulation. We do this movie here or not at all.
Now, aren't you proud of your old man, Brian? He's back in the picture business where he belongs.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's really terrific.
Well, excuse me. I have a movie to prepare.
Thank you.
Oh, no, you weren't supposed to see it now. Well, on behalf of all the people in this department, I want to welcome you back.
Oh, well, I didn't know everybody missed me that much.
Are you kidding me? After your resignation and Calvin's injury, we've been working our tails off trying to get everything together here. I don't think I've worked a straight 8-hour shift in I don't know how long.
Well, I always knew you were the sentimental type.
Well, seriously, Steve, I'm very glad you're back. This is where you belong.
Well, I'm glad I could help Paige Madison out, but I can't tell you how much I missed being part of the force. Well, when do you think Calvin's coming back?
Next week. We're going to be the Three Musketeers riding again.
Yeah, well, except Calvin will be riding a desk.
Yeah, but whose desk? Chief Marceau's. Mm. You believe we're going to be working for that guy when Chief's on vacation?
I don't know how long we'll be able to stand that.
I don't think he'll be able to stand it either. I'm sure Calvin wants to get back in action again. Speaking of action, when are you officially coming back?
Oh, this evening. All I got to do is go down and see Chief Marceau. He's going to bring back my badge. I got to dust it off and I'll be back in action.
Oh, Steve, I'm so happy. I'm so happy you're back.
It's nice to be back.
Hello, Guthrie. Well, welcome back. How are you doing?
Hello, Graham.
Yeah. Well, 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 what do you know, huh? Hey, Guthrie. Keep up the good work.
Well, I see some things haven't changed.
Speaking of change, how do you like my hair?
Yeah. Hmm? I like it.
You run your fingers through it? Excuse me. Saxon.
Is this the most arresting officer in the police force?
Who is this?
Oh, Deborah, I'm sorry. It's Owen.
That's stupid of me to think that my voice was getting familiar enough.
Well, hello. Is Paige all right? Has anything happened?
Paige?
No. You just had me a little bit worried, that's all.
Oh. Is that Owen Madison? Must be a social call.
No, I'm just here talking with Steve.
Hey, I gotta go. The visit's over.
Wait a minute, Steve.
No, that's okay. I see Chief Marceau. Sorry, I'll see you later.
Owen?
Deborah,
did I interrupt something? I'm sorry, you know, I couldn't call back later.
No, it's all right. I'm free now.
Good. You also free this evening?
I don't know about that.
Well, I think you ought to know whether you're free or not. Now, look, I'm not going to believe that you're on duty because you told me your schedule yesterday. And don't
give me that hooey about washing your hair either and cleaning up your apartment. Deborah, look, if you don't want to see me, just give it to me straight. Deal?
All right, Owen, straight. I don't think I should see you.
The word I used was want.
Owen, I have told you how I feel about this.
Yeah, I know. You told me that you were discriminating against me because I'm a married man.
Oh, don't make this hard for me, please.
Oh, come on, Deborah. I just want to talk to you. Look, something's happened to me. Something
that I just never thought was going to happen again. I'm not talking about you. I'm talking about a movie.
A movie?
Yeah, I know. Strange as it sounds, I seem to be in the movie business again, and I just want to talk to you about it.
Hey, it's the sort of thing you want to tell a friend, you know? You are that, aren't you?
Yes, I'm a friend.
Okay. Well, come on. Come meet me for drinks, all right? Will you do that?
Oh, all right. A drink. But that's all.